Start to check it. Manisha. Okay. 1, 2, 3. As per my count, because of this network and all, people are connecting and disconnecting. It's okay. So we'll see that one later. So thing is, how to practice Python is one side, and is another side is what is Python. Another side is what is Python. So you can go to the Python thing, okay? Otherwise you can go to any tutorial like kind of stuff, like W3 schools. I already told, in W3 schools Python is very easy. Python, Java, or anything you want to practice or learn, so W3 schools are very easy. Okay, okay, so very simple given in here, that's why I prefer W3 school for a starters. You want to go a little bit depth, or you want to go more, like one is a tutorial point, another one is Java T point. Java T point, not only about Java, it is give a lot of information about other kind of stuff also. See, like this, okay. So the AWS, Selenium, Cloud, ML, okay. See, here it is a Python. Python advanced, Python's, okay. Histories, why should we leave? Read it at least once. So he's given a difference between a Java program to write and Python to write. Okay, like this. What are the different frameworks and libraries? Okay. Everyone is there. So 1 second, I want to verify this candidate. Okay. Okay, so like that we can able to do it. So if you study, you will understand more, and if I take theory, it will take more time. So, but still I want to take, it is also, Python is also old language only. Okay, Python itself, it is a very old language. Like when C++ started growing into the market, so same time Python is also came up. This is the person who is behind Python, Guido van Rossum. Okay, so he write this Python thing. Okay, it is Python does not mean that the snake kind of stuff. It is a drama series based on that. So when one day this candidate and other person watching a road show, so that time he put a name like Python on it. Okay, so who invented Python, like this. When 1991 onwards it is in the market, but later it is not getting more popular, but it is it's up to scripting language only, but later it is start using into different things, and a lot of contributors. Okay, it is not like a patent rights, like my programming language, I am alone responsible. For example, if you take Java, Sun Solaris, later Oracle. Okay. Sorry. Sun Microsystem, because Sun Solaris also belongs to Sun Microsystem. Sun Microsystem is the whole responsibility development of Java, and later it is, now it is in Oracle. .NET related things, all are Microsoft related, okay, right? But Python is not like that. Python is like a more in a open source, and lot of contributions are there. Contribution means plugins, connectors, so many things are came into the Python. Okay, people are developing and adding into the Python related. So it is much developing now. So randomly and high speed development in that one. Okay, Python is a simple general purpose high level and object oriented programming language. Okay, interprets the scripting language. Okay, so like you can write the script. Script means just a code only. Script means a simple code. We can say it is a scripting code. It is used in a various things. Okay, like you are writing a scripts, mathematical related things, software development. We can develop an application side, web development. Recently, game development also came with the Python also. Okay, so used for used on a server to create a web applications. Okay, alongside software create a workflows, database systems. Okay, we can connect it to the database and we can modify or access in the databases. Handling big data, perform complex mathematics, rapid prototype and production ready software development. Okay, it works on different platforms like Windows, Mac, Linux and Raspberry Pi. Simple syntax, similar to English language. Okay, so whatever you type, it is directly we can type in English language base only. Syntax that allow developers to write program with a fewer lines and some other programming lines. Python runs on interpreter system mean that code can be executed as soon as it written. It means prototype can be worked quickly. It means whenever you write a program and immediately it will execute. Okay. It immediately start working on it. This is won't wait for compiling. Every line should be compiled, then only execute. Like if you have a Java program is there. First we have to compile, then class Java class will be generated. Dot class file will be generated. Again, when you run that class, then you will see the output. But in a Python, it automatically do both the things in a one single execution time only. Okay, treated procedural way as and object oriented way. So there's a different programming languages are there. Procedural languages, functional and object oriented. So different language types are there. For example, Java is a object oriented language. Everything you write in a Java is just like a Java program only. So like this. Somewhere it is there. Here it is. So this is everything we have to define in under classes and objects. So that is called object oriented programming language. But in a Python we can use we can define classes, objects, functions, and directly like a C language, like a procedural language, we can able to do it. Guys, there is always comes under differences. So here is important question. Difference between C and Java, right? Always, this question is a most common question. So what is the difference between C and Java? C is a procedural language and Java is a object oriented language. C language is platform based language, means wherever the application or you develop the C language, so like it will work. Like it depends upon operating system. Java is a platform independent. Just you have to install a Java runtime environment to execute a Java. Yeah. Someone is trying to tell, but I am not able to. Yeah, Ajit. Okay. So Java is a object oriented language. Okay, Java is a object oriented language. C is a not object oriented, it's a procedural language. Like you have to check it, what is C language. Okay, it is a general purpose programming language. It is software development operating system. So find out what kind of language it is. Structural programming language, how many things are there? Procedural computer programming language. Supporting structured programming, flexible variable scope, recursion, static system, like that. Okay. So if you go to the C++ is a object-oriented language, object-oriented programming language. Java is a object-oriented programming language. But Python act like a both. Python is a both procedural and as well as object-oriented language. So somewhere it is written. And also it is a scripting language also. It's a procedural and object oriented language, and also it is a scripting language. You can write a script for a different program. Different programming sites it will use, for example, like a script languages like a Perl, whatever it is you use that name. Okay, when I said Perl means it is, it's a no, sir, it is Paul something. We are more masters in English compared to this. Okay, text manipulation that use of write tasks including administration, web development, network programming, GUI development kind of stuff. Okay, this is a main one of the general purpose script language programming. So different type of script language programmers are there. Of course, like one is a Perl. Linux script is there, Linux shell scripting, of course. Ruby as a no, but better to verify, guys. Better to verify, okay. Don't go for blindly, okay. PowerShell also, we can treat it as a language. Not only PowerShell, there is a lot of PowerShell different commands. We can as a script writing is also there. So for network programming or anything, so script writing is one side. We can say in any programming or whenever you develop an application, writing a script is one part. Also writing a script in the sense of like attacking someone, or maybe accessing something or automating something, so also we can write a script. Okay, so that's, you should understand. Okay, always Python versus Java versus Python, this is also you must check it. So in interview, so any interview, so whenever you go to any interviews, so these are the common things versus differences, advantages. Okay, so that is a very important. Okay, so what are the difference between Java and Python? So Java is a platform independent, Python is also platform independent. Just you have to install the thing. What is a platform independent? Platform independent means whatever the operating system you are using, you can run that program. So very simple, you have to install their related environment only. Like a Java, JRE, you have to install in your Windows system, you can run a Java program. If you install in a Linux, so you can run a program in Linux also. Like that, it is platform independent. Same thing goes for a Python also. If you install Python in Windows, you can run a Python application or a program. If you install Python in a Linux or a Unix or a Mac, you can run a Python there also. So it is a platform independent. So there is only, it works in Windows system, only works in Linux system. It is not like that. Okay, of course, if you see .NET framework is not there in a Linux. Linux you can't install, I think, at present, because Linux we can't say we cannot. Like if you cannot able to install, means .NET program directly, it not work. Usually it won't work in a Linux based system. It is a Windows purpose only. So that's why Java is more popular, because it's independent of everything. Okay, heavy programming languages, heavy applications you can build with the Java. Okay, lot of objects we can able to define in a Java. Python has a limitations in object oriented programming language. Okay, what are the Java satisfying in OOPs, but Python not satisfying all OOPs concepts? Of course, in Python we can define things in a class and the functions we can able to define, but we can't do all the four kind of stuff. Okay, and also we will see what is this object oriented. There is a four things are there in object oriented. Okay, so object oriented programming language comes like a Java, C++, C#, and Python, R, PHP, okay, Visual Basics, .NET, like that. This is the object oriented programming language related things. Okay, so these are OOPs languages generally, because whenever the question comes up, everything it will come. So better to know these things. Okay, so usually like a Python, Go language is also comes under that one, Ruby, other things also. See, Python support all concepts of programming, but not fully. Object-oriented Python code can also return without creating it. Okay, because without creating any objects and classes, we can still use the Python. Okay. So many are there. I'll go to one of the thing. Geek for Geeks also very good one. Okay, so here it is. So these are the things in so each and website will give different ways. So actually OOPs should be there are the different things are there, but actually what is a object oriented programming language? So like this one, polymorphism, inheritance, encapsulation, and abstraction. So these four are main pillars of this OOPs concept. Okay, so object oriented programming language means this thing: polymorphism, inheritance, encapsulations, and abstractions. So why these things are there? So this is each and everything will be, we can add it. So what is a class, object, methods, message passing, that is a different thing. Okay, functioning. Okay, so like that, there will be a question compulsory. So what is that? What is a object oriented language? What are the different languages in under object oriented language? Find out and list out. Not only this, there is a so many are there. Just for example, I given. Next, what is object oriented language? Means the thing is, object oriented programming is a programming paradigm based on concept of object, which can contains data and code, data in the form of fields and code in the form of procedure. A feature of the object is that object one procedure and cross modifying itself. It is giving something. I'll give you a very simple way. It is can search here also. So when you go to the Java or here, it is very simple. It is give, they will give. So here it is given details of Java. importance is in Java only we can go details of OOPS concept. So what is this object oriented is a given such as a inheritance and data. So it is object means a real world entity like a pen, chair, table, computer, watch, etc. Okay, object oriented programming is a methodology or a paradigm to design a program using a class and objects. So you can defining objects, classes wise. So just go through this site, you will people who are not at all know about OOPS and all, a lot of sites are helpful. Just see this object. Object is under class only. You have to define a class, and inside a class, so there is a object. So if you see, it is objects like a bike, pen, a fan, a table, keyboard, like that. These are objects. Objects can be defined as a instance of class. Object contains a address, take up some space in a memory. So objects can communicate without knowing details of each other's data or code. So like that, okay. A dog is an object. To understand, dog is an object. Object because it has states like a color, name, breed, etc. As well as a behavior like a tail, like this, right? So when you define an object, so you have to tell what is the state of that one and what is the behavior of that one. So that is called an object. Class is a collection of objects. So certain objects are belongs to a single class. For example, so I'm jumping directly into the classes and objects. Okay, so I don't want to do it like that, but I done. For example, automobiles. Automobiles means like a bike, car and all kind of stuff, right? So for example, just example, I said automobiles. So that is a class. Now what is the object? What are the objects in automobiles? Different type of automobiles are there, no? So like for example, car, a car, bike, bicycle not come, car, bike, truck, bus. So these are all comes under automobiles. Okay, for example, if you take a object like a car, so what has a what car has a thing? Car has a brand. Some brand is there, no? So for example, brand Tata. Okay, model Nano. Engine, okay, engine or color. So I'll go to the color only. So why? So my mind is not at all working. Morning only. So again, changes occur. Okay, so color, for example, yellow. Okay. Like this. So it is. What is this? A mileage. Okay, so you can tell a mileage how many per liter. For example, it gave you 20 liters. Okay, so 20 kilometers per liter. Okay, so mileage. So they calculate in miles, that's why they call it as a mileage. But in India, we said it's a kilometer. Okay. So, for example, mileage, tank capacities, versions, or seaters, like each one in the properties of that car. I think, guys, this is a proper proper example or a proper understanding level of example. Okay. I think is it correct or not? Because I am not a programmer. I teach programming, but I am not a programmer. Or I'm not going to. I never go to any Java class. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Is it a proper example only?
Yes, sir.
Correct. Okay. Thank you for confirmation. Okay. Because you guys went to a lot of Java classes in both engineering and outside of engineering also. That's it. So like this, you can define in a both in a Java is a direct object oriented programming. Compulsory you have to define the class when you write a Java program. So compulsory you have to write you have to define the class and objects in the Java. At least class we have to define it. Okay, and in Python, it is not compulsory to define everything in a class and object, but in a Python, we can also do object-oriented concepts. Okay, so that's why it is both procedural and object-oriented language. Okay, these are the main parts of your OOPs concept is polymorphism, inheritance, encapsulation, and abstraction. So better to try what it is like. I didn't open my WhatsApp currently, so I will share this link. People who are not yet don't know about much Java and all, not involved more. Okay, still doubt. So this is the better one, I think. So the lot of websites are there. So that is a different thing. Sorry. Next one is already I told. Okay. Already I told this one. So in a YouTube like Durga Soft. So go through only OOPs. I'm not telling watch entire Java videos. I'm telling just basic OOPs concept. One by one, watch it better. This is 16 minutes abstract, inheritance 16 minutes and all. Okay, he will give a lot of time, but for watching, just basic understanding is important. You don't need to go for a deep and all. Later, if you want, you can go for it. Like, you know, guys, a simple way to learn. Already, I told learning is a process. In the process, what is a simple way is try something. If you understand, then go next. If you don't understand, try other things. So why we should stop at one place and we are not understanding, so we don't learn anything. So that is a lot of people think is well experienced and all kind of stuff, but they don't think about very simple ways. Okay, so here it is. Inheritance. What is this inheritance? Inheritance means when one object acquire all properties and behavior of parent, known as inheritance. Okay, so what is the inheritance? We'll see. Here it is, inheritance. Okay, so normally inheritance, as initially I don't understand what is inheritance, I ask one person, so my colleague, that explanation is like this. So what are the my parents' properties? For example, your father has a car, is there, for example. Okay, you will get by inheritance. Father has a properties. Properties means like assets are there, house or what we can say, a farming land. Okay, farming land or like that. So whatever they have, a land or a house or a building, so automatically you will get it by inheritance. From the grandfather to father to us, it will come, right? So same thing. So sharing of properties. So one object properties we can able to give it to another one. Okay, one class object, one class properties, like properties of objects is we can able to give into another class also, like that one. When one object acquire all properties behavior of parent object, so we'll take things from the parent. It is known as an inheritance. It provides a code reusability and uses achieving a thing. So like that. So how to give an example? Now I'm not in my example. Okay. Next one is polymorphism. What is this polymorphism? Polymorphism means it's a different behaviors are there. If one task is performed in different way, it is also known as polymorphism. For convincing customer differently to draw something, for example, shape, triangle, and etc. So we use this method of overloading, overriding to achieve the polymorphism. Other example, we can speak something, for example, okay. So different things behave in different way, are handling things in different way, perform in different way, like things. Okay. For example, if you take example is a actually we have to take example as a duck. Okay. So that is in a polymorphism, duck typing is there. So easy to understand a polymorphism is like a duck typing. So what is a duck will do? Okay. In a duck typing, like what duck is doing, like one side of a thing is dealing is like duck is a bird. Okay. First is a duck is a bird. A duck has some color. Duck can swim. Okay. Like that. And like so different behaviors of a simple one. Okay. So like that. That is we can call it a polymorphism. Okay. So just I'm copy pasting from here only. So why should I struggle to get it? At least one line will be there. So that's my point.
Multitasking of single person.
Yes, correct. Actually, there is a one example is there. So one is a duck one. So exactly say behavior in different places. For example, I'm a person, right? I'm a person. If I go to my place, if I go to my place, Andhra Pradesh, if I go to Hyderabad or Vishakhapatnam, I speak Telugu. Right, and my behavior, way of language is different. When I in Pune, so I speak Hindi, English languages because I don't understand Marathi, but I have to speak Marathi. See, person is same, but different areas behave like a maybe different person. Okay, so if I go to my hometown, in my home. In my room, for example, okay, in my room, in my place, okay, I eat, I sit, I sleep, or whatever it is on the do it, like whatever I'm wearing is completely different behavior. But when I go to office, compulsory different behavior is there, no? Compulsory we should wear a neat dress, tuck, belt. So, you know, when some institutes will ask us to wear a tie also, shoes, right? So wearing of dress is different. Next, I'm a trainer, so I have to give training. So I have to treat the people as students and as well as trainees. So that is my point of object there. But if I go to some place, like if I go to a restaurant, my behavior is different, okay? So like that. So different places, different type of behavior, different type of properties in a different areas. Okay. So that is one explanation about polymorphism. Still I have a confusion in encapsulation and abstraction. We'll see that one. What is abstraction? Hiding internal details and show functionality is known as a abstraction. For example, phone call, we don't know internal processing. we use abstract class interface to achieve abstraction. So directly we are using a abstraction. So what is a abstraction? So he given already example on that one. So you write a code and outside it is showing only one thing. Like here it is. Can you see this one? This is a site, and I can see how many people are joined and what are the comments. The web interface I can able to see. What is going on inside? What is there inside? I can't able to see what is going on. We don't mind about what is this. So the title is there, but what is there inside? We don't know. For example, this is a VMware workstation. I know how to use this application, title, settings, and all. That is what it is showing to us. But what is there inside? We don't know. I want to open a very simple website. That's what I'm checking. Yeah, I will go to this one only. Okay, right click. So there's something. Click inspect. So this is entirely inside a background, defining program and all kind of stuff. But what is showing outside? It is the thing. Okay. What is this? To all the public health workers and researchers, scientific community. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Abstraction. One more is there. Encapsulation. Encapsulating code into another one. Where is it? Binding or wrapping code and data together into single unit known as encapsulation. For example, a capsule wrapped in a different medicine. Java class is example of encapsulation. Java Beans is a fully encapsulated class because of all data members are here. So I have to actually tell in a Python way, but I'm just copying paste of Java thing. So you can try for a Python. This is a same, but example will be changed in a Python way. So this is a about your core definitions. So guys, people who are belongs to CSC, compulsory questions. Okay, compulsory these questions will come up. What is a class? What is object? What is a method? What are the OOPs? What is meaning of object oriented programming language? Okay, and what are the different things like a polymorphism, inheritance, encapsulation, and abstractions? People who are belongs to CSC and IT, compulsory questions are there, and others is a optional. Maybe they ask there around us. Other things also there: coupling, coherence, association, okay, aggregation, composition, like that. So many other things are there. Object oriented advantage of OOPs or the procedure oriented programming language is also, just read it, you will understand. Okay. So in a global data, you will write all the functions under one category, but here you'll write a functions in a separate under objects. So many things are there to study and read it. At least go with already I told what you understand. Just try to understand very strong in that one. That is okay. If you read it, you may understand. Okay, so you can go through. This is a Python, right? So you can go one by. You can find Python OOPs concept also. This is Python OOPs. So here also you're giving definitions and how to do syntax, how to define a object. See, car is a class. Car is a class here, and here it is, they define a function. C1 is a object. C1 is a object. So to understand the class and objects, okay, completely I divided into class and objects only. Okay, Now, this is a function only. This is the class. Car is a class, and C1 is an object. And these are the parameters. Car class. These are the parameters. We're giving. Toyota 2016. That is nothing but model name here. Okay. And display again is display. C1 is an object, and a display is a function. So display like this. So this is like a how to define a class and objects in a Python. Okay, understand guys. Car is a class. C1 is an object. In the car class, there is a function. So to write to get the information like a model number and year. Okay, so like this is here. Object contains that information. Parameters. What is a method? What is inheritance? Okay, polymorphism, encapsulation, and abstraction. There are data abstractions. Difference between a object-oriented programming language and procedural programming language. So just this is also for Python groups. Just copy those links and put it in your somewhere, like just read it when you can able to read it. Okay, so better to go through once at least. Okay. So we'll complete the Python introduction first, otherwise it will take a lot of time. Python history, so much new history things. Just you can read it, whatever thing is there. So why learn Python? Python is used in a different places. First of all, Python is easy to learn. Okay, Python is easy to learn. So just you can type. Okay, just you can type a command, you can get it very easily. So you need to learn each and every command, like Linux. We are learning every command. PowerShell, we are learning every command. Or Java, everything we have to point wise, we have to learn. Okay, so there are a lot of rules and regulations to learn to write the those languages, but Python is very easy. So for example, you want to write a C language. So first of all, you have to define hash include stdio.h void main and brackets, everything. So from 2-3 days it will take for to write at least that from hash include .h to the final this one. The structure, again, it will take 2-3 days. Again, you have to write one by one, like a printf, scanf, like this entire thing. Each and everything to learn and execute, it will take time, lot of errors. But Python to start the Python, very simple. Print hello. This is very simple to learn, easy to learn, first of all. Express language, so whatever the thing you are doing, you can able to do it. Interpreted language. Object oriented language, open source language. So you know, you download directly and install and start using it. Okay, and extensible. Learn standard library. Support GUI, means you can install some GUI libraries and you can create an application, GUI based application, you can create it. Integrated, embedded, dynamically memory allocation, wide range of libraries and framework. What is the use of Python? So they use in a nowadays, what is the more vast thing is increasing data science, data mining, artificial intelligence, machine learning. So okay, so these are a more popular getting in outside, right? So artificial intelligence and all. So you are not a programmer, or maybe you are a programmer, but still, frankly, I'm telling now, it is you are a programmer or you are not a programmer, but still you can able to learn Python. Your background is, for example, civil engineering, mechanical engineering, electrical engineering. You are not went to the C++ languages. You know, when I was after my diploma in engineering, so in my diploma I have a C and C++. So in engineering I don't have any C++, Java. I'm a electronics candidate only, electronics and communication engineering. Okay, I don't have any Java kind of stuff. So I asked some people like, is it required to learn C, C++ for to learn the Java? Some people said like, it is a better if you go with C, C++, you have a standards in that one. Okay, so I don't go with the Java. Anyway, I'm like to go for a networking part only. So I not, but now I got a chance to teach Python from last 3 years. So what happened? Last two years only. So Python, 2 years only, not 3 years. And starting I didn't teach, but I practiced little bit one by one. Okay, and after one batch there is a lot of gap in between. So meanwhile, that's why I forget things. Okay, it's not a continuous process also. But some batches having Python, some batches don't have Python. We have different profiles are there. Okay, that to last year only one batch. So okay, so what it is, my point is, even you are not a programmer, don't have any programming background, still you can learn Python. And Python is very useful in a different kind of stuff, mainly in analysis, writing up a program and all kind of stuff. You know, the thing is like a Scala. Scala and other certain things like Scala, right? Okay, this is a one kind of programming language, but PyScala also there. Scala, Python, and PyScala is also came up. Spark, this is Scala, Spark. You can see here it is one, is it PySpark? You can for a Spark application, like you can use a Scala as a language and as well as a PySpark. So everything is a Python oriented. So learning of basic Python is always easy and better for anything, and it's a more habituated. So you don't need to buy very big lengthy heavy applications to do it. So it's become a more hobby to it. Okay, so just we need a basic introduction how to write things. Okay, that is enough for a Python to learn. So there's a different ways there are using, like a data science, data mining, desktop application, console based applications, mobile applications, software development, artificial intelligence, web applications, enterprise applications, 3D CAD applications, I don't know that one. So machine learning, computer vision, image processing, speaker recognition. So you are developing something, you are to develop a machine learning related one, or maybe you are doing a IoT, Internet of Things, your background is electrical background or electronics background. Now you want to write a program, so you can go with the Python. It's quite easy to do it. Okay, this is a defining a function in a Python. Okay, so this is a difference they are giving. So this is a Java program while hello world defined. So one line, two line, and this is the comment, third line. Okay, and see, this is a closures. So very strict to write and all, but this is a hello world also display in a Python. That's why it is more easy. Popular frameworks and libraries in a Python frameworks and libraries. Okay, so these are the popular libraries for a web development, means server side web development, like a Django, Flask, Pyramid, Cherry Pie, so like this. GUI based applications, like you want to develop a GUI applications, you need these libraries like a TK, PyGTK, PyQt, PyJS, like that. Machine learning, like a TensorFlow, PyTorch, scikit-learn, Matplot libraries, like, you know, graphs we create now, so that is a Matplot libraries, CPA, NumPy, like that. Mathematics, NumPy, Panda, like that. What is this NumPy? Last time people asked, what is this NumPy? They should not ask, but they asked this question. What is this NumPy? is a programming language, multi-dimensional arrays and matrix, mainly used in machine learning. Okay, mainly they use these things in a machine learning. If you want to create an array, so then you can create arrays. Okay, Python library used for working with the arrays. Matrix, array means matrix. Linear algebra, Fourier theorem, Fourier transform, matrix kind of stuff. Okay, this is how to create an array. It is a library. First of all, you have to install numpy in a your IDE, what you can say, in PIP. Okay, so now why it is showing like this? It is my PIP is a package manager. Using PIP, we can install these packages into our system. Okay. I put enter like this. Okay, PIP install, download, uninstall, freeze, list, or like that. Okay, so you can install whatever program you wanted. Okay, PIP list. Okay, these three are already installed. PIP is already installed. Setup tools and NumPy is already installed. So here showing warning, you are using PIP version 20.2.3 and latest version is available. Okay, so you have to update. You can upgrade to the new version like this command. Okay, actually you can install like this: Python -m PIP install that numpy I say no numpy. So whatever the framework you want to install, you can install in that one. So there is a lot of libraries you can able to install. Now it is already installed, so like to show you that one, I will say like numpy. When you write it, so you have to type like this: import numpy. No, so numpy libraries will be imported to your program and you can define a arrays also. This is a numpy. So one more is there, that is called the search box is there, yeah. Panda. I'm trying to search here. Yes. Pandas. What is it? It's a data analysis library. Easy to source and analysis and manipulation tool built on top of Python programming. So using a Python, so we can build it like something is given. Analyzing, cleaning, exploring, and manipulating data. So for a pandas used for a data analysis purpose, like a big data kind of stuff. Okay, like this. What are the different tools we are using? Just go through one by one. What is it? What is a TensorFlow? Okay, like this. You can say otherwise. This is usually like a mathematical or an analysis related one. This is for a machine learning purpose. This is for a GA application purpose. This is a web development purposes. Okay, last batch they asked this question. So what is NumPy and DY? You know, some people are including this data science, machine learning and all. That's why they are asking these questions also. So that's the problem. Okay. It's okay. So no. Okay, so next, what is this? It's a print function. So default print function it is. How to do Python kind of stuff. What is this? Oh, okay, output. So the first page is enough to learn everything, and I think in my PC I have something, but I want to tell like this. So go to the Python cheat sheets. You can find lot of cheat sheets. You can download lot of cheat sheets also. Like these are the cheat sheets. I'll search in my system also, so you can go with any cheat sheets. Okay, direct PDFs are so available. So 2-3 pages of PDFs are available. Okay, so try the PDF and download a PDF and keep it in one side. Usually, if not last year, before last year, and there before last year also, almost like 2 years, what I done, I download and print out. I take one printout of the cheat sheets. Okay. Like this, not this much, very simple only. I will take it cheat sheets and take a printout and give it to student only. There is a possibility of asking questions in Java. Mainly people who are background is Java background people. People mention resume Java. Next, people who are come from CSE and IT, there is a possibility of Java questions. The major Java questions means difference between Java, C, C++, C and C++, Java and Python differences. What is Java? Oops, Java, object classes, other things about Java, like oops concepts and other things. Next, Java execution, program execution, how Java program execution and JVM. Of course, JVM is there in your syllabus, but they may ask. Possibility is there. What is JDK? What is JRE? Okay, these Java related basic questions. Mainly read about these things, four things. Oops concepts. What is object oriented programming language? What is polymorphism? What is inheritance, encapsulation and abstractions? The mainly concentrate is people who came from CSE and IT background and people who mentioned Java as a one subject in their part, and others, not only those people, others who are came from different backgrounds like a mechanical, civil, or a ECE, ENTC people also. Better to read it once, read it, or at least try to tell very basic things, because also Python has so many things. Okay. That's it, guys. That is about your Python. So we'll see one by one how to do Python kind of stuff. This is only part is theory part only, but majorly covered only object oriented program.